The aim of many immune-oncology therapies is either to reinvigorate the immune response or to initiate a novel, unique immune response against the tumour, which ultimately leads to tumour cell killing. When we're thinking about which cell populations are responsible for tumour cell killing, these are mostly T cell populations, so CD8 cytotoxic T cells, and natural killer or NK cells. To assess tumour cell killing, we use an InkuCyte-based platform, and we measure two different parameters. So we're co-culturing a tumour cell line with PBMCs isolated from healthy human donors. And then we can read out tumour cell numbers and the percentage of apoptotic tumour cells within these cultures. So this gives us information on whether the immune cells within that PBMC subset are driving tumour killing over time. One of the different flavours of assays that we run is one where we assess ADCC. So in that particular assay, we add an antibody into the tumour cell and PBMC co-culture. The antibody coats the tumour cells in a specific manner, and then that allows us to assess the amount of ADCC going on within those co-cultures. We run the tumour killing assays in two different flavours, either in a 2D format, where the PBMCs are added on top of tumour cells which are cultured on plastic, or we can run it in a spheroid format, where the tumour cells form an organoid or a ball of cells, and then we can monitor tumour cell killing in that context as well. And that particular assay setup is useful when we're thinking about antibody-dependent cellular cytotoxicity, or ADCC, and that's a very useful setting for understanding that process and whether your therapeutic's enhancing killing in that context. We can define the subsets that are responsible within the PBMC mix for killing the tumour cells using two different strategies. We can either deplete those subsets from the total PBMC mix, or we can take the approach where we purify the different subsets out and add them on top of the tumour cells and monitor tumour cell killing. And which assay setup you choose is very much dictated by what your therapeutic is and your anticipated mode of action. These assays give you critical information on the mode of action of your drug, whether you're hitting your target for the expected outcomes. So are you enhancing tumour cell killing using relevant cell biology systems before you move into efficacy models?